What is going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to showcase for you guys how to build a task framework and recurring task setup within Notion. So this is an example framework I wanted to make out for you guys for somebody who has a solid and consistent schedule. And this is something kind of similar to what I have, not exactly the same, not at all. But what I have here is something that I think can get you from having a less organized time while making your work week happen to being somewhat like me. And I mean, that's a toot my own horn here, but I do make a lot of content on a consistent basis. And I think this is a big reason why. So an example going into here, if we go into our task/event calendar, is I have all of the recurring tasks set up on the side that are based on my framework. And I then drag out things over here. And due to that reason, we have stuff that really makes it a positive and makes it a quick and easy to use workspace that then gets me on a consistent schedule where I can create all this content for you guys and keep up with my work. Now, if we go to the Notion homepage, let's do another situation. We're making some pages here. So if we go to this guy /page, go framework. I always like this guy, whatever cover you want. And then we do slash a board view, I think personally is good. So slash board inline. And then we can make this one full width for you guys. We do framework here. So let's get this synced block part set up. Building emoji, paste this guy here. So as you can see, it'll be go to the framework if we want it to. Let's go back really quick, copy this synced block, paste this guy, paste in sync, put it at the top. Then I always like to add a block under. For those of you guys that watch, you've seen that every time. And then what we can do here, which I am a very big fan of, is having a board view that's set up in a way that has like a weekly sort of view with each status. So rather than it being like, okay, let's just like put an actual week here and just redo it. Now let's make a Kanban board view that has every day of the week. So I personally put the no status guy over here, put Sunday, Monday, so we pop these guys as such, and sure, there's some sliding that may need to be involved, but I don't like this no status guy, which it didn't exist. There's a way to block that if you use the Notion add-on that I showed a couple weeks ago. But in order to make this setup work, we need to have some tasks. So let's do my job, for example, sort of, or any job that I could do. So say you have to write on Monday, so like reporting. Put a little icon here, writing. So what you can do is you can take this, put a little text. What I like to do is I put a little text here and I showcase the properties and make sure the text is shown. So we got description, or we got time. And I put a little bolded text and I put like, say 8 to 12 p.m. So it's kind of like time blocking, but with the task set up. So if we have that bolded text, and we can also add tags here. So say we want to put it for a specific type, we put like, is our task group, right? So we go task group. So this could be work. Make this guy orange. And then if we want to showcase that as well, we go to task group here. Put it above time, below the time, whatever you want. And then say on Tuesdays, you have certain tasks that you know you do at work as well. So let's take, I always like to copy stuff here and get that bolding easier. Let's say you have to do recording for a YouTube channel, side hustle. And you need to do that at 5:30 to 8 a.m. Or 7, whatever.
So you can see how this would work out. I basically fill things out. Like, for example, on Thursdays, I do my plan weeks at, let's say, 5:30 in the morning. 6. And then I'm going to fill out this stuff with some housekeeping stuff as well. So say we have on Sundays, we need to do our laundry. Do it from like, let's do it from 11 a.m. to like 12 p.m. That's kind of a time frame where I probably in real life would do it. Get this guy housekeeping. So you can see here how if we get all these things figured out, we can kind of set up a system. So it looks like what I had for mine a little bit more fleshed out. We can have all the different aspects of our life that we really need. Now, I only really have my like side hustle stuff here, but if you want to have your work stuff, your side hustle stuff at the same time, you can. I just don't use the same project task management stuff for my work because that's not what we use. And you can also do it for your housekeeping stuff. I personally could put things like do laundry in here. I don't. I like to silo it more into the YouTube related stuff for this view. I just think it's nice to have that overall look at for people because, you know, if we take another example, Google Calendar here, always get an example one ready for you guys that's coinciding with the framework. We have the same framework going on, right? So we can look at this and that's great. And the time blocks are great, but knowing the actual tasks I think is important too. Now, the reason that I don't have it synced up the exact same is because, you know, lunchtime, all those other things are subject to change during work as well as you get stuff done early with side hustle. You should know when you're doing side hustle stuff in general. Now, well, some might say, you already have that kind of labeled out here. That's true. So it's all up to preference. I'm not saying my way is the best way. I'm just showcasing for you guys what I have. So now that we have this framework set up, what we can do is now that we're right here, we can make a template buttons. And what I like to do for template buttons is we make sure for recurring task is we take a enter right here and we always leave this space up. So what should this button be called? In recurring tasks, you don't want to make your groups too large. So you can make it by day of the week if you want. I like to do like Monday through Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So Monday through Wednesday. So that would mean I could like take this template button and then I'm going to duplicate this and then make one for Thursday through Friday. I'm going to duplicate this again. So a nice quick way to change this to another, to move this somewhere would be like slash page this guy. Move these to inside the page. Move this guy to Notion homepage. Whatever the heck you're, name of your homepage is. So now it's in here. So we can take this, drag this into your task slash event calendar. Take this guy, move it over here. If you're using my templates, this will be much easier for you. Turn this guy into text and then boom, it's here. So now what you can have is a setup that hopefully you can see has some benefits to it. So if we have some spaced up blocks between these, what we can do now is actually have a setup where, let me just get some extra spacing here. Say we want to make specific tasks. We have a task in here and we have these example tasks. So like, for example, record videos. Here's an example. And we drag this guy into the different blocks that we have. So for example, we want to make sure it's under this top one. Remember, always leave the space on top. We have Monday through Wednesday. We have that. We can have a housekeeping task, do laundry. Like I said, take this task group, make it housekeeping, a little shirt action going on there. So rather than always having to use templates, you can just create the recurring task and it's really easy. So cleaning or small task. Yeah, cleaning. now we know that we need to do this on like a Saturday or Sunday. So we take this into the template, drag it down here. So then now when we press this button, it'll make that and we can drag it to the day based on looking at our framework. We go, okay, when is my framework? Say it needs to be done. Oh, 11 to 12. Perfect. And you can actually, a nice little tip here as well is if you know it's going to be the exact same, do this. So take this, put it on a Sunday or whatever day you want, put it at 11 a.m. and then drag it off of the calendar. Let's delete this guy in there. Remember to add that extra space at the top. Always make sure this is there. Now, when you duplicate this and drag it onto the calendar, it'll give it the time that you had beforehand so that you don't have to set the time manually. Because, for example, if we did this, we would have to set the time manually because it didn't have a time set beforehand. And that is how you'd make a framework and recurring tasks in Notion.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.